Good evening. Welcome to Robert's Reading Room and Reviews. I'm here to do my latest book review. I want to say it's good. It's Black History. And during Black History Month, I try to read historical books. And I want to say, if you watched my previous video of my book review I did, I was just warming up, getting started. That book was phenomenal. This book I'm about to talk to you about, oh my God, I've never read anything like it. And the author, well, he doesn't have a story in this book, but he brought these students together to tell their story. They're brushed with racism, police brutality, also flood. And when I say I never read anything like this, I was like so blown away with what I was reading. This author, I read two of his books in a series. It's been several years. I want to say it was like 2005, 2000, either it was 2004 or 2005. But when I say this book right here was everything. And I'm talking about Voices from the Bayou, Mr. Clarence Nero. I hope I'm saying your name right. Brought these students together and they told their experience, their brush with racism, police brutality, the historical flood that happened, Katrina, and then the flood in 2016, which took place in Baton Rouge. Also talked about what they was doing during the time of like Alton Sterling, who was killed in Baton Rouge. I just want to say, Mr. Clarence, you had me wanting to wave my hand on this one. If you don't know Clarence Nero, he's the author of Three Sides to Every Story, and the sequel to that is Too Much of a Good Thing Ain't Bad. And when I say those two books, I was very impressed with their work. Then I become a fan. And then all of a sudden, I was looking for more from you. And I didn't get that until, like, I want to say this book. I remember you were here. It was a book event here a couple years ago here in Atlanta. And I really wanted to go. But unfortunately, I had to work, and I hate that I didn't get a chance to go, especially after reading this powerful book, Voices from the Bayou. I won't say my favorite of one of these students. I think her name was Mary. Concasian, she talked about how her mother would talk about Afro-American, like if an Afro-American man would walk by their house, she would lock the doors and telling her daughter that Black people was filthy and everything. And the thing is, I loved about this is that even though her mother was telling her this, she didn't take heed to it. She didn't see color. She saw human beings. She loved everybody. She grew up to love Black people, all races. And I love that because 9 times out of 10, sometimes when you have a parent that's telling you something, you get the habit. You take up what they tell you to. Another story was, I didn't like, was this Pakistani student who went to school and It was dominantly black school, and how the black kids was like, you know, are you a terrorist? We need to hang you. And just, oh, it really bothered me. Another story in the book is a Caucasian white male who was talking about he didn't believe in racism. He didn't see racism. All his life, he's had black friends, white friends, and he come from a middle class, a well-off family. And he didn't believe in such thing as racism. But the thing is, if you haven't walked in those shoes, say being out in public and you walk by, say a white Caucasian woman, and she take a purse and do like this, you won't know. You wouldn't. You would be clueless. But you can't say that there's no such thing as racism. Like it's in the mind, people making up things, because that's not true. And another thing I didn't like about him was he said Martin Luther King and people like that, that Afro Americans should get over their parents and slavery and all of that. And I was like, I had to stop reading for a minute because it was really ticking me off. It really was. And to say people like Rosa Parks and then Martin Luther King, it's Dr. Martin Luther King, first of all, sir. And then it was another story with another black Afro-American male. He didn't want to watch the news because it was negative, and he didn't see the point of protesting. And I was just like, some of these stories had me like, wow, really? You see it that way? True enough, you are entitled to your own opinion. I am entitled to mine. But some of it just didn't make sense to me, period. I want to say this from personal experience. I have a friend who has a Facebook friend. I'm not a Facebook friend of this particular Caucasian woman. She has like four kids. She had them by an Afro-American male, and she will be on Facebook saying, I don't understand why they gotta have a black college. Why they have to have black this, but you laying down with the Afro-American male. How about you ask him why it's such thing as a university as Morehouse or Clark University, Hampton University or something? I mean, that kind of bothered me. I'm like, I'm so glad that I was not friends with her because I would probably let her know a thing or two, and she might not like me afterwards. But I want to say this right here. I love this. Was a book unlike any other kind I have read. I can't really say it's an anthology or anything, but it was a very good read. It consists of 126 pages, so it's a quick read. But some of it had to take time because it kind of bothered me. I want to say again, thanks to those who support Robert's Reading Room and Reviews. And I'm on Instagram, Robert's Reading Room. My Facebook group is Robert's Reading Room and Reviews also too. Please check this book out. Voices from the Bayou by, well, introduction is by Clarence Nero. Nigro, I'm sorry. And leave your reviews. I give it 5 stars. I already did my reviews on Goodreads and Amazon. So until next time, happy readings.